If this policy does go ahead, people are deported to Rwanda and people continue to cross the channel in the numbers that they have been, including to the present day, then the government will have questions to answer about value for money too.
OK, Ben, thank you. That's Ben Kentish, our Westminster editor. Lots of you phoning in. Not surprised, I have to say. Dr. Alan Mendoza joins us now, Executive Director of the Henry Jackson Society. Alan, very good evening to you. Now, very few people seem to want to come onto the airways to defend this policy. What is the defence for it?
I think defence is threefold. The first is that obviously there's long been an illegal immigration issue and problem in the UK that everyone has agreed needs to be resolved. And yet, for many years, we failed to resolve it. So there is some blue skies thinking finally on this subject in this way to look at how to solve it. The second issue is, of course, the human trafficking nightmare that's occurring. People paying criminal gangs tens of thousands of pounds to get in to the UK and potentially putting their lives at risk in the journey. And of course, potentially human slavery on the other side as well. And finally, of course, you've got the essential point that this is not actually taking away anyone's right to asylum. Asylum is being preserved. Safety is being preserved. If you're fleeing from a dangerous place, you will find yourself in a safer place as a result of still coming to the UK. And it's not a universal policy either. It won't happen to everyone. There will be determinations made before people are sent out. So I think there are many reasons why it's happening. Let's put it that way.
Well, I understand the need to get a new policy, and nobody else seems to have any idea of what policies to bring in apart from this. But what I don't understand is how it can be considered to be a deterrent to people crossing the channel. Because if they had said, well, every single person who makes this crossing will be sent to Rwanda, fine, I can see that, I might not agree with it, but I can see that's a deterrent. But if you're saying to somebody, well, you've got about a 1 in 100 chance of being deported to Rwanda, that is no deterrent at all, is it?
Well, it can't be a 1 in 100 chance. That's absolutely, you're right on that point.
It would be, though, because the Rwandans are going to take 100 people at a time because that's all the British government paid for their accommodation. That's 500 per year. So do the maths.
Well, I think you start somewhere. The whole point of this is that, as far as I'm aware, this is only the start of a scheme and the start of an idea, which is quite right. You wouldn't want to be spending more than this to have a system to work. You need to trial it first, Iain. I mean, that's the essential part of this. But to come back to the first point of what you said, no one has come up with any ideas on how to resolve the immigration crisis beyond this. And therefore, we ought to trial it and see what is happening here before we rush to judgment about whether it's bad, good, indifferent, doesn't fit the bill or does fit the bill.
Do you not think, though, it is the norm, if somebody claims asylum in a particular country, that they should be processed in that country, and if they're successful, they then stay in that country? 75% of asylum seekers who do claim asylum here are indeed successful. Surely the most shameful part of this is that if they're successful in their applications in Rwanda, they have to stay in Rwanda.
Ask yourself what asylum is, Iain. Asylum is fleeing from death, destruction, violence. As long as you're guaranteed safety as a result of that, what's the issue here in terms of a human rights point? We are saving people from the chaos of where they're coming from. And of course, the other point about asylum is the idea is that eventually you go back to your country. It's different to migration. It's not supposed to be about staying in the country forever. The point is that after a certain amount of time, when something is safe, you return. So this is simply a temporary safe haven for people, and that is being achieved by this. So I'm not sure I agree on that point.
How is it a safe haven when this country takes in dozens of Rwandan asylum seekers each year?
Well, I think, the point is that we have signed a deal with Rwanda, an allied country, to ensure it is a safe haven. There are
if it was, there would be no asylum seekers from Rwanda, would there?
Well,
would there?
Well, you'll suggest that there are some people who claim that Britain's an unsafe place and attempt to claim asylum elsewhere. The politics of
ridiculous argument.
It isn't. I don't think it is at all. I think you'll find that there are many people who've said that if X or Y government comes, I'm leaving the country, etc. Okay? So there are different points there. I believe that the government signed a deal which will be honoured by the Rwandans to provide safety and security. And it will be incumbent upon the government to make sure that's happening. If it isn't, that will be a disgrace. And that will not be acceptable for anyone if that is not occurring for the people who end up in Rwanda.
Alan, thank you. That's Dr. Alan Mendoza from the Henry Jackson Society. Jacqueline McKenzie joins us now.